Hi everyone, my name is Gaurav and today we are going to see how to create awesome link effects using the pseudo class elements in CSS. So here in my editor I have two files opened, markup.html and styles.css. So let's take a look at markup.html first. So in my markup I have a div with a class of container. And in that container, we have four sections labeled with classes in succession. So the first one has a 1, second one has a 2, third one has a 3, and the fourth one has a 4 class, okay? And in each section, we have four links, okay? So that's it for the markup. Let's take a look at the styles now. In styles we have these color values, color hex values, so we can use them later in this example. So first of all I am removing the default margin and padding, setting the font to Vardena, and for the section I'm setting the padding to 150 pixel on top and bottom, displaying them as a flex, setting the justify content property to space around, align items to center and background to that dark gray color, okay. For the link, I'm setting the text decoration to none, color to white, font size to 22 pixel, position to relative, because later we can absolutely position these pseudo class elements, and giving the transition of 300 milliseconds and ease in out as a timing function. And the pseudo class elements, I am setting the position to absolute, setting the transition to 300 ms, ease in out, okay, and removing the pointer events, okay. So for the first example we are going to target the after element, so let's select that. Let's set the width of after element to 100%, height to 2 pixels, background to white, and let's set the position left to 0 and position bottom to negative 5 pixels. Let's see what we have got. So here you can see the line below the link elements has added. So now what we need to do is we need to hide this line by default, and when we hover on these links then we need to add that line back. So how we are going to do that is by using the scale transform scale property, okay. So transform scale, let's set it to 0, okay. So now the line has disappeared. We can set the hover state, okay, hover after. Let's copy that, let's paste it here, and let's change it to 1.1, so the line will be little bit wider than the link elements, okay. So let's see what we have got. So now you can see this interesting hover effect we have created using the pseudo class element. I think it's like a rubber band, two people are pulling the rubber band and then they are leaving it. So let's move on to the next example now. So let's target the next element first. Let's change the background of it first. Let's copy this blue color. We are not getting the blue background. What is the problem? Oh, so now we are facing it here, specificity problem, because we have declared the dark gray color as a background here. We are not getting the blue color on the second example. So what we can do here is remove this container and let's save it. Here it is. So now we are getting that blue color. Now for the second example, let's target both the pseudo elements before and after. Let's set their position top to 0%, left to negative 10%. Let's set the width of it to 115 pixels, height to 2 pixels, and background to white. Not getting this. How these are getting this line? How are they getting these lines? Container A before and after. Oh, we need to type 2 here, okay? Okay, here we go. And let's change the sum of the styles to after, okay? Let's set its width to from 115% to 2 pixels, height to 0%. So now let's set the hover state now. So again targeting that hover state of the link, and then the before element, what we need to do is top from 0% to 105%. Okay, so here we can see it's already a interesting effect. And let's not stop there, let's add another thing. So 2 hour after let's change the height from 0% to 105%, okay? So now you can see it's a very very interesting effect. Let's move on to the next example now. Let's add a comment first. Third hour effect. Let's select that section with the class of third. First, change the background of it let's give a green background to the third section. What's going on? Third. Oh, the class is 3, not 3rd. So let's change that. So now we have got the green background. Let's target those pseudo elements before and after. So in this example, let's try something different. Let's set the top position to 0, left to 0 as well. Height to 1 pixel. Background to a dark green color. Okay, let's see what we have got. No width. Let's give a width of 1 pixel for now. Let's set it to 3 pixels so we can see here. So here you can see a small, dash has appeared. Let's change some of the setting for the after element. Let's set top to auto, and also I'm selecting both these elements and setting top, left, height, width. These three things are common, but these two properties will change for before and after. So I can do like this also. Okay, so 3a before and 3a after. So these three things are common for those. Okay, and later we can target them individually. So top 0, left 0. So now we don't need to give top auto property for after element. We can give bottom 0 and right 0. Okay, so now for the hover state, hover before. After, we need to change the width of it from 3 pixels to 100%. Let's change it to 0%. Okay, so now if you hover on these links, you will get this effect. Both the elements are changing their width from 0 to 100%. So let's move on to the last example now, the fourth and the last example. So let's add a comment first. Fourth hover effect. First change the background of it. This beautiful red color. Okay, once we got the background, so let's add some empty space at the bottom. So how we are going to do that is by adding a empty div and giving him a height of, you know, 300 pixels. I think 300 pixels will be enough. Let's see. Okay. So in the styles, we already set its background. So now let's target those pseudo class elements. So before and after. First thing, we need to set their position. So left to 0. Let's set width to 100%. Height to 1%. Let's see. 1% has no impact. Let's increase it to 3%. What is going on? Oh, we haven't given a background color. So for the background, we'll give a semi-transparent red color. So 2 to 5, 0, 0, and for opacity, let's set 0.3. Okay. Okay, so now let's target them individually. So for the before, we need to set the top property to 0, and I think that pretty much it for the before. And for the after, let's set the bottom property to 0. So now what we need to do is when we are hovering over it, we need to change their height from 5% to 100%. Okay, so let's do that. A hover before comma a hover after, just one change from 5% to 100%. So here we can see the both the elements are changing their height from 5% to 100%, and we get this very very cool effect because they overlap each other and it looks very very cool. So that's it my friends, we have created four link effects, link hover effects using the pseudo class elements. So the first one is a rubber band effect, second one is a kinda cool, it's a tiff, very very unique. Third one is also great, and this is the fourth one. Okay, so if you have any suggestion for any future videos, so please write it down in the comments below. Please like the video if you find it helpful or interesting, or if you learn something from it. So that's it guys, have a nice day and see you soon, bye.